So hi everyone, this is Samreen again signing in from Boston. In today's video, we are going to discuss what we can do if we don't have any research experience before applying for master's or PhD positions that are funded. So what we can actually do in those cases is you can prove your research experience through some other ways, even if you don't have research publications. The first and foremost and the most one of the strongest indication of your research experience would be your final year project or your master's thesis if you have already completed your master's, which means that you can show your experience with your BSc, like your bachelor's final year project or your master's thesis, and you can mention the skills you learned in that project or in that thesis, even though that is not published yet, or you decided your supervisor decided not to publish that further. But it's okay, the skills you learned while doing that research are still valuable, so I would suggest you can mention those skills in your application. You can mention those skills in the email that you're going to send to your potential supervisor. So if you have no final year project or final year project or thesis experience, then I would suggest what you can do is look for volunteer opportunities. There are a lot of labs who would love to hire volunteers. There are a lot of supervisors who would be ready to take volunteers in their lab. There would be a lot of postdoc who would love to have volunteers to help them with their projects. So try to find volunteer opportunities and then explain the research skills you gained from those volunteer opportunities in your email or in the admission letter to show that these are the research skills that you have gained during your academic journey so far. If you cannot find any research experience, like any volunteer experience, then one of the, I would say, relatively easy thing to do would be to start your own blog. You can start your writing blog, you can have your own website domain, and you can talk about science in there. You can talk about very specific niche that you are an expert in and try to write every day, try to write every other day, try to maybe if it means sending one tweet a day, just send that tweet explaining the latest research in the field, explaining an interesting paper that you read recently. These all can serve as your scientific communication proof, and these all can serve that, okay, you know your field, you know what you are talking about, and you're really passionate about it, you're really interested in it, and that's how you can convince your potential supervisor to hire you in their lab. You can also start a YouTube video and try explaining complex science concepts to general audience, or complex science concepts to undergraduate students, and that would be itself like a big deal. You can mention that YouTube link in your application or in your email template that you're going to send, email body that you're going to send to your supervisor, and that's how you can also explain that you are capable. It's only that you didn't get a chance to do the final year project, or you didn't get the experience to do hands-on research, but you still have a lot of experience in evidence generation, in right data generation, in scientific research, in data analysis, and then making conclusion and understanding research from those published papers. So it is still valuable and it does still count. Other things you can do to support your application is, like, if you have volunteered in a lab, request that PI or request that supervisor to also be your referee on your application, so they can also mention about your skills that you have learned in their labs, and they can also talk good about you and your science. So that would be helpful in also in making your application strong. If you have worked as a final with a supervisor as part of your final year thesis or a master's thesis, you are more than welcome to add that supervisor as your referee, so they can also strongly support your application, and they can also talk about your research skills. So all these things combined can make your case strong, and it can still help you win funded opportunities, even though if you don't have any published paper yet. So if you have done a thesis or a project, you can always send and apply to different conferences, go present your research as a poster or as podium presentation in different conferences, and that can also be highlighted in your resume that you went and you like submitted your research in conference and you were like you showcased your research to diverse audience. So it can also be like your research presentation skills, it can also come under your research experience. So all these things, little by little, but they all are valuable in making your application strong and making you an excellent candidate and convincing your supervisor to choose you over other candidates. So happy searching, guys. Best of luck and see you guys soon. Take care. Bye-bye.